Hello, everyone. My name is Corey, and I'm a content and support engineer here at Geocodio. Today, we're going to talk about the best ways to format your spreadsheets to get the most accurate possible result from our spreadsheet uploader tool. Let's go ahead and get started. From our homepage, we'll go ahead and click the Upload Spreadsheet button. You can also navigate directly to this page by going to geocodio/upload in your browser. Our spreadsheet uploader is designed to be easy and intuitive to use, but there are many ways to set yourself up for success. We'll walk through the upload process at the end of the video and see what kind of results we get. But first, let's discuss some formatting tips to keep in mind when you're creating spreadsheets. You can use whatever software makes sense for your project. We accept a number of different formats, including XLS, XLSX, CSV, TSV, and zip files. In this case, I've got a CSV open in Google Sheets that I would like to upload and geocode. There are three major factors to consider when formatting your spreadsheet. First, your spreadsheet must have headers at the top of each column, preferably in the first row. We use headers to identify and reference the columns we'll use to retrieve specific data. You can name the header anything you like. For example, if you were geocoding Canadian addresses, you might want to use province instead of state. Let's go ahead and change that. We would still be able to find the information we require regardless of what this column is named. During the upload process, you get to choose which columns contain the appropriate address components. Next, make sure that your formatting is consistent across the entirety of your spreadsheet. There are a number of ways that you can input data into the spreadsheet uploader. You can split the address into multiple columns as shown here in this particular sample. You can also place the entire address in a single column, like I've done here. When reverse geocoding, the same is true. You can split the latitude and longitude into two separate columns, or you can place them all into a single column, like this one right here, where each coordinate is separated by a comma. The important thing to remember is that once you've chosen the format that you would like to use, it needs to remain consistent throughout the document. If you decide to use a multi-column format, you shouldn't have rows that contain a full address, and vice versa. This could potentially cause errors and prevent us from being able to get the correct results. If your spreadsheet includes addresses or coordinate pairs in multiple different formats, you will need to split them into different lists. So, for example, if I had a bunch of addresses sort of all completely entered into column A at the bottom of this spreadsheet, I could just split them out into a separate spreadsheet like this one. A couple of other considerations. Street number and name should always be in the same column, even if you're using a multi-column format. We don't have a means of concatenating that information on our end, so you need to have both the street number and the street name in one place. When using a multi-column format, we also recommend splitting the address into four or five columns: the street address, the city, the state, the zip, and in some cases, the country. We'll talk about that more in just one second. Finally, when inputting zip codes into our spreadsheet uploader, be sure to use standard zip format. We do not accept zip plus four inputs at this time. It's important to note that we only ever add columns during the geocoding process. We never delete them. So if you have other data stored in your spreadsheet beyond address information, that will be retained in your result. If we take a look at this spreadsheet that I've already generated, you can see I included a business name column before the address column. This was included with my finalized spreadsheet. Geocodio added all of these columns on the end, but everything else remained the same. The last thing to check before uploading your spreadsheet is only important if you plan on geocoding addresses in Canada. If this is the case, be sure that you include that information at the end of your address or coordinate pair. For example, if you are using a multiple column format, add a fifth column called country. That allows you to define the address as either the US or Canada. If you are using a single column format, you can then add the name of the country at the end of your address string. Now, this particular address is not in Canada, But just as an example, it would look just like this. So you can kind of get an idea of how you would want to format that string. Quick note, currently we only offer forward geocoding of addresses in the US and Canada. No other countries will provide a result. If you are reverse geocoding, we can return Mexican addresses as well. If no country data is provided, we will always default to the US. Now that we know the basics of how to format our spreadsheet, let's talk about a few more things that might help you to receive more accurate results. Your addresses don't always need to be complete. They just need to be formatted the same way. You can see in my sample spreadsheet that there is some incomplete data. In these rows, I don't have information about the city and state. In these rows here, I don't have information about the zip code. This will not stop us from providing geocoded data. Still, the more information you provide, the more accurate the results you will receive. If you want rooftop-level accurate responses, we do require a street address in order to find the specific locations. We also require either a combination of the city and state. In this case, actually, I never switched it back, so let's go ahead and do that. I'll change that back from province to state. So we either require a combination of city and state or zip code without a street address. You can leave off one or the other, but if all we receive is the street address, you will likely receive an error. If you provide a city and state combination or a zip code without a street address at all, we will return the centroid coordinates for that region. This is the centermost point when taking all of the boundaries of the city or the zip code into consideration. Here's an example spreadsheet where I only input zip codes. You can see that they all return place level accuracy. And the reason for that is that we aren't given any specific address information in order to be able to find the rooftop. Lastly, when reverse geocoding, be sure to provide both coordinates with latitude first and longitude second. They must be in that order. Otherwise, we won't be able to interpret the data accurately. Now that we've got our spreadsheet in order, let's get to uploading. We'll go back to our spreadsheet uploader tool, and then we'll go ahead and start by uploading our file. So let's go here, and then I'm going to go ahead and grab this sample list split headers CSV. Once the spreadsheet has been processed, we can verify that the input columns match each part of the address that we require. You can adjust which header is associated with which data type by using the drop-down menus that we've provided. Say, for example, I can see here that my street address is matching the address column on my spreadsheet. Same thing is true for city, state, etc. Before moving forward, be sure to check the boxes at the bottom of this section to make sure that the format looks correct. Then, if they do, you can go ahead and hit preview. So I can check here and see 475 H Street Northwest in the US. You can see that this one's a little bit weird, right? So we might want to go back and fix that if this was another situation. But some of our other ones look a lot better. 800 F Street Northwest, that's basically exactly how we would expect a Washington, DC address to look. Since we're good to go, let's go ahead and hit that preview button. In this section, you'll see a sample map with plots pointed representing a few of the rows in your spreadsheet. This should match the regions you would expect to see data points. So in my case, I mostly geocoded locations in Washington, DC. I also geocoded a few in Toronto. So we can see that those match up with my expectations. If you don't see any points at all, you may want to go back to the first step just to make sure that the data is being imported correctly. In this case, everything looks good, so we'll go ahead and move forward. In the third step, you can elect to add different field appends at the expense of additional lookups. This could increase the cost of your upload. We're going to skip this step for now because we just want a basic geocode. Finally, we want to agree to Geocodio's terms of use and hit the start button. We will upload the spreadsheet and add the requested fields to your spreadsheet as quickly as we can. In this case, it's going to move real fast because it's a pretty small spreadsheet. And let's go ahead and open it up to see what we've got. All right. It looks like everything was a success. We've geocoded each of the addresses, returning coordinates that match their location. We've also parsed out the address a little bit further down in the spreadsheet here and provided an accuracy score to determine how accurate the result is versus your initial input. So you can see those accuracy scores here, as well as an accuracy type. However, you can see that one of our addresses wasn't able to be geocoded. We've got a little bit of an error here. It says postal code or city required. This is because we didn't provide any information about its city, state, or zip. So we want to make sure that we have this available. Otherwise, there's really no way for us to be able to geocode the address provided. The vast majority of our results return with high accuracy scores at rooftop level. However, there are a smattering of results with slightly lower accuracy scores. This can happen for a myriad of reasons. Maybe the address is a new construction and doesn't exist yet in our system. Maybe the address doesn't exist at all. Sometimes we aren't able to find the exact address, but in cases like this, where the result is range interpolated, that usually means that we were able to find something close on the same street. And on some occasions, we just haven't received data on the location from its local municipality. We regularly update our database with new addresses, and if there's something you can't find, you're welcome to report it to geocodio/report, and we'll do our best to research why that error might be occurring. Regardless, by following these tips, you should ensure that you get the best possible results. I hope this has been a helpful guide. And if you have any additional questions that I didn't cover, feel free to reach out to support@geocodio. If you'd like to try out Geocodio, you can sign up for an account and receive 2,500 free lookups per day at no upfront cost. Until next time, happy geocoding.